2002, Taga, we went to Jamaica for Christmas with his girlfriend. On the way back, he was arrested by the police and he was sent to prison for 6 months. I didn't have any money. They phoned me from Jamaica. They want money for to put down his prison time. £1,000 to, instead of 6 months to go in prison, to be to it three. I didn't have no penny at all. I couldn't help him. I was thinking. I cry. I remember that night I cried. Then I thought about, I have to start making some money. My son needs money there. So I say, I'm gonna start selling wheat, because already they used to come in our house smoking. So I started myself. I was making money, as was sending to, and I was doing good business, and I was making money, which I was very comfortable and support my son, sending him £300, £400, £500 a week.
Got the ballocks?
Yeah, I got the ballocks. Of course, yeah? I got the ballocks.
Let's see the ballocks.
And
the ballocks?
Got the ballocks.
The best you can get.
Yeah.
This year, it was okay, but the biggest trouble was when the people come to rob me. All right, boys? Yeah. 5 times I had approached.
Come.
The guns in my body.
Give me the weed, Pops. Come on, man.
I had very hard time.
Pops, where you going, Pops, man? Right. Come here, Pops.
I've been working very hard.
You don't want to pop one in your face, Pops?
Fucking around.
I was very good in knives. I was.
Stop talking and get me the fucking food.
The commando when I was 18, and I've been trained on knives. And I was very fast. Once.
I don't have to do something, man. What? You got a knife?
One of the holding the gun, he would lose his half of a hand. I was so good in knives because I cut his hand half. I didn't want the whole hand in my kitchen. I wanted to run, to go, because of the police, of course. I don't want a police. I have weed in my house. Well, he hold his hand and ran away. He got the hand. He went to hospital, wherever. Four of them he was. Supplying weed to hundreds of people. Well, I start because of my son went to Jamaica and I was arrested. He went to prison, so I need money to support him. I've been to prison myself and I know how things are. So a young boy been to Jamaican prison, I was worried. You know. I know Jamaican prison is a tough place. I have friends still in making business with them in the weed, and I know what kind of prison is Spanish town. They told me. I've been informed of everything.
What did they tell you?
That's what the reason. That is it's very tough prison. Spanish town prison. That's why I was worried. Not because he was white, it doesn't make no difference. When you are in prison, you doesn't look no white, no black.
couldn't believe what the judge said to me. And the judge looked at me and said, you get a year.
A year? A year? In that prison in Jamaica, a year? I said, no, judge. Felt to cry and die same time.
They make you strip nearly naked to see if you've got any scars on your body. And you basically get received as a body. When you make it out of the prison alive, you come out as a body, you know? But when you come out as a live body, it's a different story. That prison is designed for them to kill them one another. There's no toilets in the cell. There's no water in your cell. I never eat the prison food yet. I never seen nothing like it in my life. You don't get no plates, you don't get no forks. If someone ain't send you in a container and a plastic fork, you ain't got nothing to eat out. Well, I see people come back from the tray with food and all that, man.
On the floor is like a sewage going across on the right hand side, like a little sewage tunnel. Stinks like shit. And then on the wall is just cockroaches. It's covered.
I must have made around 25, 30 people when I got in a lockup in a small little area where you got about 20 people lying on the floor on newspaper. So when we were just going to the man, them just give me a bit of newspaper and I just went in one corner and sat down, vexed.
Nah, man, me tell him straight. As a Ras, me smoke herb and we get caught with some herb. Yeah. And them give me a sentence. Yeah. I get that sounds dog in a trouble, you know, and we see an article with his name, even though I never know his name, but I know his address. I just look out for him still, because I know he's going to land on a certain date, so.
He phoned me and he said, that man is here. I was glad. Not because, of course, Talman, he was in prison. He went to prison, but he was in prison anyway. So he's next to my son. They know each other. That's why he was glad. I talked to Talman in the telephone as well. Yeah. Talman is a good man. He's a good, I know him long. He's straight, man. I like him.
Yeah, because you have two sections at a prison. Yeah, salt block and NCB. Certain parts rougher than the other, you know? Well rough, so. Try to keep him away from that section, yeah.
I saw four people dead in there. I see a Colombian brother in there who was locked up for coke. He only had 6 months. He went mad in his cell, mad just like there, trying to kill himself in his cell with other people going mad. Because you can go mad in a place they're not strong. Do you get what I'm saying? Really, 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 really. That place that'll drive you crazy. You have to be really strong.
Togo was nervous, frightened, you know. Strange place, locked up. You see the stress on him still, but he conquered that. Had to.
Pretending, I think, myself. Whatever he was talking to me, that he was okay, this and that. But me, by the way he talked to me, I knew he wasn't okay. No, and I was happy, of course, after when he was talking to me with confidence, I know he was okay. That's why I was run to send him money to survive.
If you're going to prison for herb, a man not treat you no bad way for herb. If you're going to, for raping a one and something like that, it's a different thing. Them not check for that.
Like you get rated by what your charge is. If you're charged for rape, then you get treated like a pussy, basically. If you get charged for coke, you get treated like an idiot as well. If you get charged for thiefing, you get treated like an idiot. If you get charged for murder, then they consider you a bad man. If you get charged for gunshot, you get considered a bad man. If you get charged for weed, you get considered a freedom fighter.
Well, revolutionary in the sense he's providing a service where not any and any man will do, you know. I mean, I say even though every and every man wants for smoke herb, not every and every man wants to travel with it. But some man brave enough to travel with it. I just say it go. I think Dougal got through by being himself. When him find out say he can't really chat. You know. Make things easier for him, you know? And in no time, he was doing his own thing. I walk around and I chat lyrics. And man just get around and listen to him chat. So he was like a little celebrity in there, you know? So when you meet people that do it on a professional scale and they react to what he was doing, I think that's what built him up still. Destiny is destiny, man. You can't stop destiny. No one can't stop destiny, you know? And sometimes what you think is the worst of worst is always a blessing behind it, you know? But life not simple as man try to make it. Man try to complicate everything, but life is a simple thing, you know? But most people imagine it when you're behind bars, everything over and done for you, you know? But from you know, kill a man, I have blood on your hand, you know? Not really. Little herb. And a crime. Crime what? When Togga leave prison, it's a full transformation. Different person. He's like, he find himself.
I want him to come back, but his life is music, so I understand that. So I tell him, okay.
If you didn't buy the ticket,
you'd be deported.
No, I was meant to be deported. If you didn't buy the ticket, I would have been still in prison.
Oh, I see. Yeah, yeah. I didn't pay that. Yeah.
You did. You paid the £500. You bought the ticket.
From where I went?
The embassy. The embassy.
Yeah.
Remember
yeah.
The English lady, the embassy.
Caroline, yeah, there.
And I didn't go. I didn't even get on the flight. I didn't get on the flight. I stayed in Jamaica. Yeah. But without buying that ticket, you get sent to the remand centre until someone buys you a ticket.
Okay.
Ah, yeah, yeah. Ah, this is a good story, yeah, I remember
that's
now.
That's a good part
okay.
to say.
The moment I saw that little white English boy, I know, he was a star. For real.
I'm a white man, that's what I'm subversive with. I'm a white man, I'm supposed to play this too. I'm quite a quiet DJ.
And him, give me one tune. I ought to owe him, give me the first tune. It's like me, I said, no, sir. I'm the baddest white boy that's here in a long time. No, sir. I said, no, give me one more tune. I don't go so boom and jump in and next tune again. I said, damn, no. You know, so I look at where I'm normal. So it's like, I see it in him right away. You know, I said, you know, so him. I want to start him. Right, this up. When I met him, it's like he might tell me in personal life, like, he might tell me, say, yo, boy, Jigga. You know, the GM does come from, and, you know, all of that stuff. And I said, damn. You know, so I'm really looking straight, dude. So I start feeling realness. You know, I said, all right, you up. And they don't know me as a youth, eh? Like I said, from me to the star, I give my hand. So this one, I just say, all right. I give my hand. You know what I say? Give my help, because at a time later, like, I think, like emotionally, you know what I say, he probably didn't need a friend them time. You know what I say? Like, because he's just coming off a whole bunch of problems and coming out of jail and, you know, and he never really know a lot of people in Jamaica. And you know what I'm saying? And I saw all of that like in a minute and I said, you know what? This dude probably need a friend, you know what I'm saying? The whole, all them period of times, you know, my name's on bridging and thing and we done start showing the ropes still. Came in the studio them and start recording and thing and the key thing was each time I put him up on the stage to represent, he represent. And I have a lot of shows so. At that time, he was going to a whole heap of corner with a good pan, and then I bust the place. So every time we go around, we just give him the mic. And just bust the place, every community. So in a quick 6-8 weeks, like him at the whole Kingston town. But yo, the white boy, we have Power Nexus. You don't see the white boy, we have Power Nexus. You know what I'm saying? In a quick time. In a short time, we did like a whole show, a whole heap of places. And I think we ended up with Sting. We ended up with Champions in Action. Ended up though. Talk of one, represent
me represent
for the major
show them. Give me love, me fuck them, tell me, but they bend me.
Who love that blood?
Hey, yo,
Tivoli God,
you know,
a
chicken.
Hold on, the Tagawar. Hold on, hold on. Me a show wicked. At England him come from. And him have a tune to represent for Jamaica. Tagawar, give them that tune there.
Yeah, you don't know. Timberly Garden, I'm in name Tagawar. I'm in a banya, but me anya. Look! Me no banya, but me anya. Request to the farmer.
They must plant
the Jojo, yam and the banana. Don't let you know what they give me a great marijuana. Me love Jamaica, me no live on ya. Everybody, look!
Like, I got this thing early. Just to see that's the part of the show they call. Tagawar, not even because he was my friend, but like I said, lyrically, he was spitting. You know what I mean? He was spitting on the real Jamaican thing to like, and he might chop the patato, and he might chop the thing them where I happen in Jamaica too, and they get the thing them where the girl them want here too. You see what I'm saying? So like, from that come up, we just say, all right, no itch, no question. Tagawar all the way, man. And him do it. You know what I mean? Him come through, man. Come a sting, rip it, murder.
So, ladies and gentlemen, here comes Tagawar! Tug and one.
Me na banya, but me anya. Request to the farmer.
Me na banya, but me anya. Respect all the farmer. And then, never must smoke the marijuana. I'm gonna stand up in the crowd like. Yeah, man.
Them things gonna happen every day, man. Nah, like. It's more like a destiny, you know what I'm saying? It's more like a party, you know what I'm saying? Because them things not really happen so, every day, like. You know? One in a million, man. No, never say for real, one in a 20 or one in a 30. Not really happen every day, man. Because, like, our business is hard, you know? Our business is a very hard business, man. To impress people in our business and to get to the level where you can get in just a short time, you know?
Important thing, the most important thing is him come to Jamaica and him lay that foundation. Because everybody in Jamaica knows about one. So it's like everybody right now, they're just listening out for that one hit there. Bam! It's over.
I was heartbroken to fly out, fly from Jamaica. Anyway, I didn't want to.
Yeah, like it's like. When he flew out to Jamaica, it's like the whole Jamaica was like, hey Lexus, where's Tug of War? Tug of War, Tuggy. I'm like, yo, he went back to England. And everybody like, for real? Oh, damn. You know, if he had stayed there for 1 more month. Just 1 more month.
Before I left Jamaica, I was offered a recording contract with Steely and Cleavey, which is the biggest producers in Jamaica. And I never got to sign that and record any stuff with Steely and Cleavey because my father was in prison. I had to fly back out to England.